Go ahead.
Okay, good morning. Are you listening to me as well?
You're audible.
Okay. Good morning. My name is Matheus Gomes Nascimento, and I developed this project with Paulo Batista Lopes. And the title of the article is Thermal Comfort of Environment with Internet of Things, Big Data, and Machine Learning. The research received financial support through the MEC Pesquisa Merit Benefit Model 2 of the Postgraduate Program in Electrical and Computer Engineering at Mackenzie Presbyterian University, São Paulo, Brazil. About me. My name is Matheus Gomes Nascimento. I am 24 years old. I received the Bachelor of Science degree in Electrical Engineering from Mackenzie Presbyterian University. And during the undergrad course, I was a monitoring student in the subjects of the electrical circuits and applied electricity. And I also participated in the robot research and the development group. And macrobotica. I'm currently a scholarship student in graduate program in electrical engineering and computing in Mackenzie Presbyterian University. My current research interests include big data, Internet of Things, machine learning, and thermal comfort. In parallel, I work at Valid SA, a Brazilian company developing and implementing RFID and IoT solutions. About today's agenda, I will start with a brief introduction to the topic, talking about the first studies on thermal comfort, the objectives and the factors that motivated the development of the research will be addressed. In concepts and theoretical framework, the parameters used to measure the thermal comfort of the environment will be discussed, as well as the technological concepts involved. In materials and methods, I will present the architecture of the project, explain the function of element in context, and then the results. And finally, the bibliographical reference used. And since the beginning of human history, men trying to protect himself from heat, cold, and the other animals in close environments, such as caves. These shelters, in addition to providing security, were responsible for promoting thermal comfort, regardless of the external environment's conditions. According to American Society of Heating, Refrigerating, and Air Conditioning Engineers, thermal comfort is a mental condition that expresses the body's satisfaction with the environment. The first studies on the thermal comfort started in the last century, and their main objective was to evaluate how the environmental conditions change the performance in the working day. Nowadays, with IoT and big data, it is increasingly common to combine the use of sensors with intelligent platforms. At work, the monitoring of the environment will be carried out with the collection of temperature and humidity. In this figure, we can see the evolution of the number of IoT, big data, and machine learning search over time. And the objective of the work is to make possible to assess the environment in real time and also make prediction about these parameters. Using the temperature and humidity, the comfort index will be calculated and will the data collected, the analysis and the prediction of the parameters will be made using machine learning. According to literature used, few companies adequately consider the level of the thermal comfort in their facilities. According to World Health Organization, thermal discomfort increases people's heatability and tiredness, reflecting on productivity. Another justification is the aging of the population as a global phenomenon. According to the United Nations Organization in 2019, there were 703 million people in the world over 65 years of age, and by 2050, that number is expected to double. This age group faces difficulties surviving dependence, making it impossible to support all the individuals close to family members in nursing homes or medical centers indefinitely. This project will make it possible to intelligently monitor the environment and context for each individual, making it possible to remotely track the condition of the environment. And thermal comfort is a mental condition that expresses the body's satisfaction with environment. The human body is always exchanging heat with the environment, and this exchange should take place without effort. When a person's body feels cold or hot, the body will make a greater effort to maintain the temperature. This additional effort negatively impacts ideal health conditions. In addition, they compromise performance in the daily activities. For analysis of the environment, the heat index, thermal discomfort index, and the temperature and humid index will be used. With the calculation of the index, it's possible to access the environment with alert levels and also possible physiological symptoms of individual presence in the environment, which can range from simple fatigue to a possible stroke. The analysis of thermal comfort uses big data storage, processing, and analysis tools with data collection through IoT device and parameter prediction using machine learning. To analyze how much the population can suffer from thermal discomfort, the heat index, thermal discomfort index, and temperature and humid index have been universally used in industry, health, and civil engineering. The idea of calculation comfort index aims to relate several variables into a single parameter. The heat index is a measure to define the intensity of heat a person feels, relation the air temperature with the relative humidity. The thermal discomfort index and the temperature and humid index are also calculated using the air temperature with the relative humidity. They are important parameters to determine whether the environment provides thermal comfort for the people, relation the alert levels and the physiological symptoms. In table one, we can identify the level of danger and its relationship with the heat syndrome using heat index. Heat syndromes range from possible fatigue or prolonged exposure to stroke. And the relationship between thermal discomfort index and danger level is shown in table two. And the thermal discomfort index were used to determine the percentage of the populations suffering from discomfort or otherwise. The relationship between temperature humid index and danger levels is depicted in table 3. For temperature humid index value less than 21 degrees Celsius, the environment can be considered partially uncomfortable. Based on the theoretical reference, it was possible to assess the level of comfort in the environment by measuring the index of thermal comfort used. The assessment consists of judging the level of comfort in the environment, considering the level of danger and possible physiological symptoms for the individuals present. For data collection regarding air temperature and relative air humidity, IoT modes were used. H1 illustrated in figure is composed ISP32 board connected to a Wi-Fi network and DAT11 temperature and humidity sensor. The temperature and humidity collection models were installed in the rooms of household location in metropolitan region of São Paulo to analyze the comfort levels of the place. The house is an habited B3 adults who work remotely and share rooms with each other. The models were deployed in living room, kitchen, office, bedroom, and bathroom. The figure presents the proposed and implemented architecture in this work. IoT prototype collects environment parameters and transmits them using Wi-Fi network to the LAMPEN server installed on a Raspberry Pi 3B Plus that contains MariaDB database and two scripts. And the database stores all the information collected by the IoT prototype, enabling future analysis and consultation. The script post as that data is responsible for inserting the information collected by the IoT prototype and storing in the database. And the as data requests all the content stored in the database, which can use it to integrate the proposed solution with the other existing systems. The visualization can be done through the scripts, also using Grafana and MindDB tools. iScript ASP.Data display all the content stored in the database through the web page when HTTP request is made, as shown in figure. And the sensor data table structure is specified in figure. And the data collection was started in June 17, 2020, and on November 20, and 2021, the sensor data table had over 2 million records with a size of 184.7 megabytes of storage. About Grafana dashboard, the presentation of the data is carried out through the Grafana tool, which connects to the database, making it possible to consult the stored information and display in through the tables, graphs, and statistics. And the Grafana platform is widely used for monitoring systems to generate real-time graphics using dynamic dashboards. In the tool settings, it's also possible to configure alerts to notify the user in the case of abnormalities. For the best visualization, I have speeches figure. At the top of the dashboard, it contains the sensor selector responsible for filtering the data according to desired room. The times interval selector for the analysis and also selector that determines the data update rate in the interface. The select room, the sensor collection period, and the number of stored reading are displayed through panels. And the dashboard displays the minimum, average, and the maximum of each parameter, as well as graph of parameters as a function of time, according to the interval on the environment defined by the user. And the last data stored in each environment are also displayed through tables containing the data of the collection, humidity, temperature, the comfort index, the heat syndrome, and the status of each parameter. For the project, a Gmail account was created, enabled for connection for external programs to send alerts parameters in the dashboard for each analyzing environment. It was necessary to install the STFC MTP package on the server responsible for automating the transmission of emails via the command line so that the Grafana servers triggers alerts. And the dashboard was configured to average the temperature and humidity of the last 15 minutes and trigger alerts in the conditions that the parameters are outside the defined range. In this figure, you can check the alert settings and the history of registered alerts. If the parameters return to the recommended condition, an email will be sent to the user with the interruption of the alert state in the environment. Alerts will also be sent for errors and in the execution process, timeout or missing or null values. And this figure illustrates an example of email sent to the admin email to verify the environment as soon as possible. About MindsDB dashboard. MindsDB is an open source tool for automating machine learning projects that allows you to quickly and efficiently build and train predictive data model using standard SQL language. The tool allows you to connect directly to a database to create artificial intelligence tables that return forecast truths and SQL query, supporting the analysis of numbers, tests, categories, timestamps, and types of images. Predictions are obtained using AutoML algorithm, ensuring accurate results in the short period of time, requiring the developer to select the data and perform and an initial configuration for MindsDB to automate the entire analytical process to generate the model. And data was analyzed with the average of parameter per hour to increase efficiency, reduce the amount of data and process costs for each model. Each machine learning model implemented has its own data set that contains only the data relevant to predicting the specific parameter in each environment. The data set used to predict heat syndrome, for example, contains only the data, temperature, humidity, heat index, and heat syndrome. There are the models calculated in the project. The WHO status model uses logistic regression, k-nearest neighbors, decision trees, support vector machine, and naval Bayes algorithms. For the other models that use multi-class classification, the tool uses k-nearest neighbors, decision trees, naval Bayes, random forest, and graduation bushing algorithms. The models are trained using the different algorithms to assess with the most efficient using the time required for training and accuracy to make the correct predictions. After calculation of the prediction model, a report is generating specifying the number of samples used for training and testing phase of the model, the relevance of each feature to the model, the confusion matrix, and the model accuracy. This figure presents a report generated in MindsDB after calculation of the predictor model of humidity in the living room. And the confusion matrix is a NXN matrix that allows the extraction matrix to assist in the evaluation of classification models, with N being the number of target classes. The matrix compares the actual data with the data predicted by the model, and it is possible to identify the model's performance and the probability of success and the error for each target class. The confusion matrix of the model correct she predicted 99% of positive results and 90% of negative results, with overall accuracy of 93.8%. Accuracy describes how often the machine learning models correctly classifies a data point, that is, the rate at which the model makes a correct prediction. The greater the accuracy of an algorithm, the lower the risk for making decisions using the model. Accuracy is obtained by summing the number of times the model predicts the true positives and the true negatives by the total of number of predictions. Detailed predictive analysis of environment parameters in the kitchen, bedroom, and office can be achieved using the reports generated in MindsDB, and the same process described for the WHO status living room. This table shows the accuracy of each predictive model calculated in each analyzing environment. And this figure contains a comparison between actual and predicting values of temperature and humidity in living room as September 16 in 2021. And the average difference between actual and predicted humidity was 1.77%, with a maximum variation of 6.09%. For temperature, the average difference was 0.67 degrees Celsius, with a maximum variation of 2.54 degrees Celsius. In this context, it's important to note that the predictive analysis was performed in an environment with no barriers to protect from external temperature or humid sudden variations. This is the main reason why there is some deviation from observed actual data. About the results, the IoT architecture was implemented, the platform allows integrations via endpoints with other systems, real-time analysis of the environment using Grafana tools, and predictive analysis of the environment using MindsDB tool. For future work, the number of IoT devices will be increased, and the current LAMP server replaced by a cloud server to ensure there is no reduction in performance while increasing demand from the server. Thus, server resources will be increasing during the calculation of machine learning models and also scaled according to the number of the devices and sensors. And there are the references used for the presentation. Thank you so much for everyone's attention.
Thank you very much, Matthew. It's a very good presentation.